Today I'll be making something really sweet and spicy recipe. Sometimes we may have excess idli. If you don't like to eat in conventional way, then you can try this recipe. Here I have about 10 to 11 idlis left over. First, I'm going to take one idli and cut into 4 pieces like this. I have to cut it in lengthwise pieces, and this way I'm going to cut rest of the idlis. Next, we are going to be making very simple batter. Okay, to do so we need salt 1/2 teaspoon, turmeric powder 1 pinch, and we also need baking soda, maida 1 cup, corn flour 1/2 cup. Mix all the ingredients together and then add water little at a time. We are using about 2 1/2 cup of water to get coating consistency batter. Now heat oil in a pan. Once the oil is hot, take 1 piece of idli, dip in the batter, shake off, then throw in the hot oil. We have to put one at a time. Make sure you turn the sides. Fry the both sides until golden brown. As you can see, the fried idli turned out to a beautiful reddish in color. That is because of reaction of baking soda and turmeric. It will take about 3 to 4 minutes to fry each side. Now idli pieces are done. Take out the crispy fried idli on a tissue paper. So here is some batter left over. I'm gonna be adding a little bit of water to dilute it, and later I'll be using it as a thickening the sauce. Now we are gonna be making honey chili sauce. For this we need 1 teaspoon crushed chili flakes, honey 2 teaspoon, black pepper powder 1/2 teaspoon, vinegar 1 teaspoon, soy sauce 2 tablespoon, 4 tablespoon ketchup, sesame seeds 2 teaspoon, crushed peanuts 1 tablespoon, chopped garlic 10 to 15, 1 big onion chopped. Heat oil in a pan, add chopped garlic and saute for few seconds. Then I'll keep adding rest of the ingredients one after one. Now goes in sesame seeds and keep sauteing. Then we have onion, chili flakes, black pepper, crushed peanuts, and give it a gentle stir. After stirring and cooking for another few seconds, add vinegar, soy sauce, ketchup, honey, and saute again. Add some water to make it little saucy goodness. Let it come to a boil. Now add the fried idli pieces and toss it. Keep tossing it for another 1 minute or so, and then add leftover slurry, just 1 tablespoon, and give it a mix. It will thicken the sauce. Now our honey chili idli is ready. No one can imagine that this honey chili recipe made without potatoes. Let's serve it. Sprinkle some more roasted sesame seeds. If you like this recipe, please hit the like button, share with your family and friends, and don't forget to subscribe to my channel.